Thank you so much for joining us. This is Adventist Angels Watch on the Radio, your number one Christian radio, sending waves to the ends of the earth. The Bible in the educational work. The Bible is the highest value because it is the word of the living God. Of the countless books that have flooded the world, it is the most deserving of study and attention, for it is eternal wisdom. The Bible is a history that tells us of the creation of the world and opens to us past centuries. Without it, we should have been left to conjure and fable in regard to the occurrences of the remote past. It reveals to us the creator of the heavens and the earth with the universe that he has brought into being, and it sheds a glorious light onto the world to come. The Bible is a field where are concealed heavenly treasures, and they will remain hidden treasures until by diligent mining they are discovered and brought to light. The Bible is a casket containing jewels of inestimable value, which should be so presented as to be seen in their intrinsic luster. But the beauty and the excellence of these diamonds of truth are not discerned by the natural eye. The lovely things of the material world are not seen until the sun, dispelling the darkness, floods them with its light, and so with the treasures of God's word. They are not appreciated until they are revealed by the sun of righteousness. The Bible contains a simple and a complete system of theology and a philosophy. It is the book that makes us wise unto salvation. It tells us of the love of God as shown in the plane of redemption, imparting the knowledge essential for all students, the knowledge of Christ. He is the sent one of God. He is the author of our salvation. But apart from the word of God, we could have no knowledge that such a person as the Lord Jesus Christ has ever visited our world, nor any knowledge of his divinity as indicated by his previous existence with the Father. God has not only revealed to us the doctrine of the atonement, holding out the hope of eternal life, but his words are the manna from heaven for the soul to feed upon and receive spiritual strength. The Bible is the great standard of right and wrong, clearly defining sin and holiness. It is living principles running through our lives like threads of gold, are our only safeguard in all trials and temptations. The old scriptures were the essential study in the schools of the prophets, and they should hold the first place in eternal or in every educational system. For the foundations of all right, education is a knowledge of God. The old scriptures were the study in the schools of the prophets, and they should hold the first place in every educational system. For the foundation of all right, education is knowledge of God. Use it as a textbook in our schools, the Bible will do for mind and moral what cannot be done by books of science or of philosophy. As a book to discipline and strengthen the intellect and ennoble, purify and refine the character, it is without a rival. God cares for us as intelligent beings, and he has given us his word as a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Its teachings have a vital bearing upon our prosperity in all the relationships of life. Even in our temporal affairs, it will be a wiser guide than any other counselor. Its divine instruction is the only way to success. There is no social position, no phase of human experience for which the study of the Bible is not an essential preparation. But the mere reading of the word will not accomplish a result defined forever. It must be cherished in the heart. The Bible has not received the close attention it deserves. It has been honored above every other book in the education of children and youth. Students devote years to education, they study different authors, and become acquainted with science and philosophy through books containing the result of human research. But the book that comes from the divine teacher has to a great extent been neglected. Its value is not discerned. Its treasures remain hidden. An education of this character is defective. Who and what are these men of learning that the minds and character of the young should be molded by their ideas? They may publish with pen and voice the best results of their reasoning, but they grasp only an item of the work of God, and in their short-sightedness, calling it science, they exalt it above the God of science. Man is finite. There is no light in his wisdom. His aided reason can explain nothing in the deep things of God, nor can he understand the spiritual lessons that God has placed in the material world. But reason is a gift of God, and his spirit will aid those who are willing to be taught. Man's words, if only of value, echo the words of God. In the education of youth, they should never take the place of the divine word. Call philosophical speculations and scientific research in which God is not acknowledged a repulsive injury, and the evil is aggravated when, as it often the case, books placed in the hands of the young, accepted as authority, are depended upon in their education, are from authors avowedly infidel. Throughout all the thoughts presented by these men, their poisonous sentiments are interwoven. The study of such books is like handling black coals. A student cannot be undefiled in mind who thinks along the line of skepticism. The authors of these books, which have sowed the seeds of doubt and infidelity broadcast over the world, have been under the training of the great enemy of God and man, the acknowledged head of principalities and powers, the ruler of the darkness of this world. The word that God has spoken concerning them is, they become vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools, because that when they knew God, they glorified not him as God, neither were thankful. They rejected divine truth in its simplicity and purity for the wisdom of this world. Whenever books by these inhibited authors are given the precedency and the word of God is made secondary, a class of students would be set out of the schools no better fitted for the service of God than they were before they received their education. It is not for want of evidence that men doubt the divine truth. They are not inhibited through ignorance.